This is A DeWalt. DW995 or 55. I'm not sure. As you can see, the label's torn away. When I ordered the parts for this, I remembered. I identified it. But for right now, I'm going to show you how to identify or diagnose a broken trigger or bad trigger and how to replace it. Right now, I have all the screws out of this drill. There's a screw there, 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 and a screw right there. This one is a T10 Torx, and the rest are T15 Torx. Just to remind you, this is a Torx. It's like a little star. These are two screwdrivers I was using. Here's the screws, what they look like. If you lose any of these, the site I'll tell you to get the parts from, you can buy them for about 95 cents each. Okay. Now, if you think your trigger's bad, or something's screwy with your trigger, I put this back together to show you. There we go. I didn't reconnect that. Well, anywho, if you press the button and nothing happens, or the brake isn't working correctly, a lot of times it's a trigger. I already pulled this all apart, and I did not connect this right here when I put this back together. I just put this back together so I can show you. So you're going to want to take out your battery, take out your screws, which I already have, and you're going to want to take your clamshell off. This is a clamshell, the yellow part. I'll do that.
Relatively easy. These shells are,
depending on what drill you buy them for, they're about 10 bucks a piece if they're cracked or something. See, this is your little speed changer, direction changer right here. I did not connect it. Usually when you buy a trigger, it does not come with one of these, so save that. Like an impact driver that I'm also going to fix, it actually came with one. Here's a trigger for it right here. Don't really need that, I'll just keep it as a spare part. So here's your trigger assembly. Now as you see, the one wire goes up to the side like that. That always goes on the back end of the trigger. And one goes straight up, goes there. Or you could go black, red, however you want. I usually go like that. Because on Sawzalls and things like that, I got a couple Sawzall wires up here. Like, here's a Sawzall wire right here. It's brown. Brown, purple. There's a purple one in there somewhere. Yep, there's a purple one right there. Brown, purple. So, a lot of times you don't remember that. Because most people are used to positive, negative, red, black. Alright, so here's your switch. I'll show you how to diagnose it right now. We're in the bottom of the switch. The switch is kind of like, if there is a computer in this thing, it's a switch. And that's the screwiest problem I've found so far. Alright, so I'll plug the battery in there like that. Make sure you plug it in so the bigger side of the battery is on the trigger side. Or you can short out the battery or whatnot. Just have some problems. But usually that's not a big deal if you reverse it. But if you reverse it on a charger, if you put the battery wrong on a charger, you can get yourself in some trouble there. Because that's actually current and a current. Alright, so see that? Nothing's happening. Oh, look at it a little bit. See if it's not always doing it. See for a couple minutes there, it wasn't doing nothing. And when you're trying to, if you're up on a ladder and you're trying to put in screws, you're not going to want that to happen. So, yep. So it's definitely a trigger. Show you in a second how to, well, first, you're going to want to disconnect these wires, and I'll show you how to diagnose the motor and make sure it's not the motor. Remove the switch, and you're left with two wires. Put the battery on its side. touch one wire to one. Try to get it to stay in there. I'd usually do this with two hands. Works fine. Reverse them. And it works fine. So then you know that it's your trigger. That to the side. This trigger's no good. You don't repair triggers, you just replace them. Here's a replacement trigger right here. If you'd like to find parts for all sorts of tools, ereplacementparts.com. ereplacementparts.com. That's where you're a very good place to get them. So they're about the same price as the they're pretty much the same price as the DeWalt website. Just the nice thing about that website is, like, this saw right here, I had an identical one come in, and I could find parts for that too. That's what this is from. This breaker switch. That's actually my saw right there. The contractor, he had the same saw, so I just took parts off that, fixed his saw, wham bam, one night, and once the parts get in, I'll just put them on my saw. I don't use my table saw very often. The problem with that is it had a cracked wheel and it had a bad breaker. So I tripped over my breaker in case I needed it. So works fine, you know. Sometimes you gotta do those sorts of things. Just get things out of here. Because before, this place was a mess. There's all sorts of crap in here. So I'm like, I can't have this saw sitting around. So here's your new switch. Nice and clean. So it looks like should fit in there just like the other one. See, they're identical. Alright, so what you're going to want to do is wire going at a 90 degree angle to the clip. You're going to want to go there and this wire going straight up. You're going to want to go there. Alright, so I'm going to put those on and I'll be right back on. Now you've got to take your switch, and now see this right here, this little part right here goes right in here, see, right in there, and then this little part right here goes closer to the trigger, because when you put this in the center, this thing locks the trigger, so it can't be used if you're trying to keep your kids from using your drill. Alright, so I'm going to put that in. It's very simple. If you didn't understand it, should be able to figure it out. So I'm going to put that in. Alright, I've got it in there. And there it is. Should move freely. There you go. Kind of got my fingernail there. Taking off the taking off a starter on a lawn tractor. So, your drill trigger, throw it away. It's no good. Here's your clamshell. See, everything's in there, all nice and neat. Alright, now this right here, this wire, these wires you gotta watch out for. This red wire right here, very troublesome. So try to tuck it in right behind here. I'm gonna do that right now.
I got that wire tucked behind there. I'm gonna put the shell back on. Alright, got the shell back on. I haven't put the screws in. The trigger can be kind of troublesome when you put the shell back on. Make sure you put it so it's in left, going in the left, or reverse. That way the trigger will stick up more, and you can put slide the shell right on it. So, yep, I'm going to put in the screws, and as I remind you, one here is a T10, the rest are T15 Torx. Alright, put the shell back on, put all the screws in. And now's the moment of truth. Take your battery here. This one hand. Battery's in. Now let's try it on left again. The new trigger. Works just fine. Locked. Left. Right. Works just fine. This is a more expensive drill. This trigger costs about $50. Depending on what you're replacing it for, it may or may not be worth it. As in, for the impact driver, I'm going to repair for the same guy. $30 the trigger cost. Right now, he had me switch out some parts on a Sawzall. He had a XRP DeWalt cordless Sawzall, and the handle shattered. Well, not shattered. Some holes scraped through. And he had another one that had a broken reciprocating unit, like gearbox stuff. That was all broken. Good handle. Good trigger. So I switched out the handle and the trigger and took the old trigger.
Anywho.
So yeah, I took the trigger out of the Sawzall and I put it in his impact driver so he could use it. That only goes right because it's a Sawzall. Sawzalls don't go left or right. They go left, or they go right or off. So I just made it so he could use it because I had two of his drills. So yep. Alright, so hope that helps. It's not that hard. A lot better than buying a new drill.